अब आ जाते हैं हम लोग सिम्पसन्स 3/8 रूल पे एंड कंपोजिट सिम्पसन्स 3/8 रूल. सी द जनरल न्यूमेरिकल इंटीग्रेशन फॉर्मूला इज इंटीग्रेशन फ्रॉम एक्स जीरो टू एक्स एन वाई डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू एन इन टू एच विद इन ब्रैकेट वाई जीरो प्लस एन बाई टू फॉरवर्ड डिफरेंस ऑन वाई जीरो प्लस एन इन टू टू एन माइनस थ्री बाई ट्वेल्व सेकेंड ऑर्डर फॉरवर्ड डिफरेंस ऑन वाई जीरो प्लस एन इन टू एन माइनस टू होल स्क्वायर बाई 24 थर्ड ऑर्डर फॉरवर्ड डिफरेंस ऑपरेटर ऑन वाई जीरो प्लस सो ऑन. वी हैव सीन दिस फॉर्मूला अर्लियर फॉर ट्रेपेजॉइडल रूल एंड सिम्पसन्स रूल 1/3 रूल. Now we substitute n is equal to 3 in 1 in this equation and obtain integration from x0 to x3 y dx is equal to 3h within bracket y0 plus 3 by 2 forward difference on y0 plus 3 by 4 forward difference of second order on y0 plus 1 by 8 forward difference operator of third order on y0 and other differences they are neglected because they become 0. So its value comes out to be 3h y0 plus 3 by 2 y1 minus y0 plus 3 by 4. Write the value of this one y2 minus 2 y1 plus y0 plus 1 by 8. Write the value of this one. So this is y3 minus 3 by 2 plus 3 by 1 minus y0. After calculation, we get it is equal to 3 by 8h y0 plus 3 by 1 plus 3 by 2 plus y3. So this is your Simpson 3/8 rule. Now we move on to find the formula for composite case. Similarly, we can write integration from x3 to x6 y dx is equal to 3/8 h y3 plus 3/4 plus 3/5 plus y6 and so on. Integration xn minus 3 to xn y dx is equal to 3/8 h 3/8 h within bracket yn minus 3 plus 3 yn minus 2 plus 3 yn minus 1 plus yn. Now add all these equations and we get add all of the above and get integration from x0 to xn y dx is equal to 3/8 h within bracket y0 plus 3 y1 plus 3 y2 plus 2 y3 plus 3 y4 plus 3 y5 plus 2 y6 plus so on plus 2 yn minus 3 plus 3 yn minus 2 plus 3 yn minus 1 plus yn. This is called composite Simpson's 3/8 rule. After this we will see some examples based on this one. So let us see examples on Simpson's 3/8 rule and composite 3/8 rule. We will write the rule once again. Simpson's 3/8 rule is integration from x0 to x3 y dx is 3h by 8 y0 plus 3y1 plus 3y2 plus y3. And Simpson's composite 3/8 rule is integration from x0 to xn y dx is 3h by 8 y0 plus 3y1 plus 3y2 plus 2y3 plus 3y4 plus 3y5 plus 2y6 plus 1 plus 2yn minus 3 plus 3yn minus 2 plus 3yn minus 1 plus yn. You can write it in another simpler form, this is equal to 3h by 8 within bracket y0 plus yn plus 3 times y1 plus y2 plus y4 plus y6 plus 1 plus yn minus 2 plus yn minus 1 plus 2 times y3 plus y6 plus 1 plus yn minus 3. We will use this formula to solve some examples. See, there is an example. Evaluate integration from 4 to 5.2 log x base e dx by Simpson's 3/8 rule. It is given that you take h is equal to 0.2. See the solution. For h is equal to 0.2, n will be b minus a by h. So b is your 5.2, a is your 4. So this is 5.2 minus 4 by h means 0.2. Its value comes out to be 6. Hence the tabulated values means the first row will contain the values of x and the second row will contain the values of this function log x base e. So the values of x start from 4. Next, we will add 4 plus 0.2 is 4.2, 4.2 plus 0.2 is 4.4, 4.6, 4.8, 5.0 and 5.2. So these are x0, x1, x2, x3, x4, x5 and x6. And the corresponding values of log x base e, log 4 base e is 1.3863, log 4.2 base is 1.4351. Similarly, log 4.4 is 1.4816. Log 4.6 base is 1.5261. Log 4.8 is 1.5686. Log 5.0 is 1.6094. Log 5.2 is 1.6487. So this is Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4, Y5, and Y6. You can get these values of log X base E after using a scientific calculator, or there is a logarithm table. You would have studied in your intermediate class about logarithm table. So you can write this table very easily. Now Simpson's 3/8 rule gives you integration from 4 to 5.2 log X base E dx is equal to 3 into h/8. So 3 into h means 0.2 by 8 within bracket y0 plus y6 plus 3 y1 plus y2 plus y4 plus y5 plus 2 y3. See, all the values are given here. You just need to substitute all the values and solve this one. So its value will come out to be integration from 4 to 5.2 log x base e dx is equal to 3/40 within bracket. Y0 means 1.3863 plus Y6 1.6487 plus 3 1.4351 plus 1.4816 plus 1.5686 plus 1.6094 plus 2 into 1.5261. After evaluation, it comes out to be 1.8278. So this is the solution of the given problem. There is another example. Evaluate integration from 0 to 6 dx by 1 plus x square. Here your function y is 1 upon 1 plus x square. This is your a, this is your b. By using Simpson's 3/8 rule, see the solution. Here it is given that y is equal to 1 by 1 plus x square. Take h is equal to small, h is equal to 1. Then n will be b minus a by h. B means 6 minus a means 0. So this is 6 minus 0 by h means 1. Its value comes out to be 6. So n is 6. Hence the tabulated values of x and y, they are given below. See the tabulated values. The first row will contain the values of x. So it will be x0, x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, and x6. The second row means y is equal to 1 upon 1 plus x square gives the values 1.50000, 0.2000, 0.1000. 1 by 17 means 0.05882, 1 by 26 means 0.03846, 1 by 37 means 0.02703. How these values are obtained? See, x0 is 0, then x1 will be 0 plus 1, means it is 1. x2 means 1 plus 1 means 2, x3 will be 2 plus 1, 3, x4 is 3 plus 1, 4, x5, 4 plus 1, 5, and x6, 5 plus 1, 6. So these are the values of x, and this is what? 1 by 1 plus 0 square, because this is the function. So 0 square is 0, so it is 1 by 1 means 1. Similarly, 1 by 1 plus 1 square means 1 by 1 plus 1 means 1 by 2, 1 by 2 means 0.5. This is 1 by 1 plus 2 square means 1 by 1 plus 5. 5 plus 1 means 1 by 1 plus 5 means 0.2000. This is 1 by 1 plus 3 square means 1 by 1 plus 9 means 1 by 10, it is 0.100. And so on. You can calculate very easily these values. This is your 1 by 1 plus 4 square. 4 square is 16, so 1 by 17. Or divide 1 by 17, so you get this one. This is 1 by 1 plus 5 square means 25. This plus 1 means 26, so 1 by 26. The value is this one. This is 1 by 1 plus 6 square. 6 square means 36 plus 1, 7, so it is 1 by 37. So this is the value. Now, we apply here Simpson's 3/8 rule. So Simpson's 3/8 rule says that integration from 0 to 6 dx by 1 plus x square is equal to 3h/8, and within bracket we have y0 plus y6 plus 3 times y1 plus y2 plus y4 plus y5 plus 2 times y3. See, this is your y0, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5, and y6. Substitute these values here. So this is 3 into 1 by 8 because h is your 1. And this is y0 plus y6. So if you add this 1 and this 0.0273, so it will be 1.0273 plus 3 into y1 plus y2 plus y4 plus y5. Add this y1 plus y2 plus y4 plus y5. Its value comes out to be 0.79728. And last one is plus 2 into y3, means this is your y01, y3. So 2 into 0.10000. So this is the value substituted. So after substitution, we get 1.35708. So this is the solution of the given problem. So you can see that these problems are very easy to solve. You just need to remember the formula, which formula is to be applied here. So this is all over from my side. In our next class, we will study about Boole's rule and midpoint rule. So you just note down all of them and also take the screenshot. If you have any difficulty, any query, you just message me here. And this lecture will be available on YouTube very soon. There is a comment section. You comment all your queries there.